You are now listening to the Scrolls Podcast.
Cole, you stupid.
I'm a survival scroll. Cut that dude.
Yeah, I'm back. Scrolls Podcast, y'all know what I do. Y'all know who I am. This time around, we're going to change the format. I wanted to keep it a little more lighthearted slash comedic and just put some funny shit out there that I found. Well, not that I found. It's last week at work, this trucker came in and we were just shooting this shit and he asked me if I ever seen his list. And the name of the list is the 10 Dumbest Lottery Winners. Now, anybody that talks to me on a daily basis knows I love just asking random shit. Like, if you hit the Mega Millions right now, for $20 million, what's the first thing you buy? Or if you hit for $500,000, how much money you giving out to people around you? Like, how much looking out you gonna do? And this list is right up my alley, because this shit is so funny. I'm talking about, these people are stupid beyond measure. So anyway, without further ado, I want to get into the list. 10 Dumbest Lottery Winners. Number 10, Christina Goodnow. Christina Elizabeth Goodnow's name was certainly indicative of her situation, at first anyway. All seemed good now as Christina won $1 million on a $1 million jackpot ticket, which is something most of us would deem impossible. You're damn right. But wait, this is the dumbest lottery winner list. So, what went wrong? The woman bought the ticket using the credit card. Man, this shit must have. Bought the ticket using the credit card of her boyfriend's late mother, which is, you know, a crime. Investigators discovered this, charged her with identity theft and fraud, took away the money, and threw her in jail. Talk about a major buzzkill. It's like, how stupid do you have to be to not know you can't use a dead person's credit card to buy a fucking lottery ticket? But you know what? I'm not even going to get into this. One's dumber than that. We're just going to keep on rolling. Number 9 was Jose Antonio Cuatoc. Cuatoc. I'm going to look some of these people up and see where they at today. But anyway, this is a buzzkill and a whole roller coaster of emotions. Tony Cuatoc was an illegal immigrant living in Georgia when he won the $750,000 playing the lottery. Because he wasn't a citizen, he had his boss, okay, dumbass, Eric Cervantes, cast the ticket for him. And y'all know where this is going. However, the Fort Valley business owner kept the money for himself, claiming that he gave Cuatoc money to buy the ticket for him. But the story doesn't end there. After suing Cervantes, he sued his boss, dumbass, for the money and winning back the $750,000. So he got the bread back. He got the money back. Cuatoc now faces deportation after his undocumented status was discovered. Sounds like there might be a lesson here. Maybe you shouldn't play the lottery if you're living in a country illegally. Now, it's like his lawyer is fucked up for that, because unless he just went to court without a lawyer. But either way, going into a court system and you not even a citizen, like, you got to know at some point this shit was going to fall apart. Once again, we're going to keep rolling. Number 8, Sharon Tirabassi. Tirabassi. After having to live on welfare and then going on to later win 10 million, it's understandable that you want to splurge a little. However, a woman from Hamilton, Ontario, learned the hard way that there's a big difference between splurging and spending all your money till you have almost nothing left. After Lottery Super 7 winner Sharon Tirabassi spent her truckload of cash on a mansion, fancy cars, designer clothes, flamboyant vacations, and, you know, typical rich people stuff, her stash was all too soon depleted. 9 years later, she is now working part-time to support her family and living in a rented home with her 6 children. So you didn't have enough sense to know that you can't just go ball hard and you got six kids. Now your goofy ass is back working that Family Dollar, not knowing what the fuck you eating for the rest of the week. But anyway, number seven, Willie Hurt. Yes, we assume he has been hurt. That's what I said. These people, whoever wrote this article was talking shit. They said, yes, we assume he has been hurting after losing all his money. Okay, we're done with the puns. Now, you keep them coming because these people are stupid. In 1989, William Hurt won $3.1 million in the Michigan lottery. Oh, this motherfucker was from Michigan. Well, but rather than use that money to advance his life, he did the complete opposite. Within two years, he was in the middle of a divorce, which took a chunk of his money, lost custody of his children, and had already thrown away most of his fortune on drugs. It's probably meth head. Specifically crack cocaine. This nigga smoked up $3.1 million worth of work. Oh, and he was also charged with the murder of his girlfriend. Jeez, he smoked a bitch. Like, oh, you gonna divorce me and take my money? This one is actually kind of sad now that we think about it. It's sad, all right. Number six, Ebi Ronciali. R-O-N-C-A-I-O-L-I. Ronciali. While these stories all have unhappy endings, E.B. Ronciali's is particularly sad. After winning $5 million, E.B. spent the money lavishly, buying her son a house, going on gambling sprees, and giving another son from a previous marriage around $2 million. Hold on, you won $5 million, and you gave $2 million of that to your ex-husband's son. Sounds like she was fucking that son. But anyway, after carelessly spending their winnings and hiding this, as well as a few other personal problems, EB's husband Joseph was found guilty of her murder via the injection of a lethal concoction of painkillers. Man, these people is... Alcohol was also found in her system when she died, so he got her drunk and doped her up, trying to get the rest of that bread up out of her. Much to the... chagrin, I don't even know what that means. Much to the chagrin of EB's family, he was sentenced to only 7 years in prison in 2008. He probably looked at that shit like, hey, that's worth it. I get the rest of that money, and we in there. Number five, Denise Rossi. When we see selfish behavior like this, it can be hard to not laugh at the misfortune that follows. After winning $1.3 million in the California lottery, Denise Rossi filed for divorce, shady bitch, from her husband, Thomas Rossi, without telling him about it 11 days later. This obviously left him in an understandably perplexed. Her lack of disclosure was an effort to keep all the cash to herself. Yeah, we know that. Shady bitch. But after he found out, Thomas sued Denise. And because she had violated state asset disclosure laws, this is in California, reminder, he was awarded every cent of her $1.3 million jackpot, which left Denise poor and single. What can we say? Karma's a bitch. So was Denise. Denise is a bitch too. So this lady hit for 1.3, divorced her husband. He found out, sued her, got all the money and left her. Serve you right, bitch. Number four, Americo Lopez. Workplace lottery pools are a common thing. This already don't sound good. Mind you, I'm reading these fresh with y'all. Like, I skimmed over a couple of them, and then that's when I said, I can't just keep these to myself. So I'm finding out with y'all. Workplace lottery pools are a common thing, but they can certainly cause some unnecessary drama. A group of construction workers from New Jersey pulled their money, and one of them, this motherfucker Americo Lopez, had the job of buying the tickets. After they won a hefty $38.5 million in 2009, he cashed in the ticket and kept the winnings for himself, stupid as hell, and promptly quit his job. After a co-worker did some investigating and found out the truth, though, Lopez was taken to court in order to split the money between himself and five ex-co-workers. Though with such greedy behavior, maybe he should have lost it all. I was just thinking that, like, you got off lucky. Like, they took you to court. I mean, he tried it. You know what I'm saying? You got $38.5 million and tried to dip out, but that shit wasn't going to work out like that. That's too much money. Them people are going to hunt your ass down, Americo. Number three, Michael Carroll. This guy is such an idiot that they made a documentary about him. Young Englishman Michael Carroll hit the jackpot at only 19 years old, winning nearly 10 million pounds, which is roughly 14 million US dollars. After claiming that he wouldn't spend the money lavishly, yeah, all right, he spent the money lavishly. He bought a $50,000 BMW, a Mercedes, a lakeside mansion, steel balls, which he used to catapult into shop windows. This motherfucker just buying anything he can put money on. And lots of cocaine and hookers. Lots of cocaine and hookers. After eventually running out of money due to his excessive partying, the now divorced Lotto Lout has since taken a job in a biscuit factory. Boy, you went from $14 million to working in a biscuit factory. I'm surprised that none of these people committed suicide. That's the craziest part about all of this. But we almost getting to the end. Number two, Andrew Jackson Jack Whitaker Jr. In 2002, Jack Whitaker won an astronomical $314.9 million, which was at the time the largest jackpot ever won by a single person in American history. Whitaker chose the cash option of $113 million. Damn, out of $314 million, cash is $130. Where the rest of the money? Anyway, but it all went bye-bye. While Whitaker donated large sums of money to charity, he also became careless. He lost 545 bandos, 545,000 in cash after thieves broke into his car. His granddaughter's boyfriend was found dead of a drug overdose in his house, with his granddaughter herself also found dead a year later. And he was sued by a casino for $1.5 million in bounce checks. That motherfucker was fucking up. He burnt it, man. Burnt money. BMF. Finally, in September 2006, it was alleged that Whitaker claimed thieves took the rest of his fortune by cashing in multiple checks. Sounds like a setup to me. No honorable mentions this time around. And here we are, folks. We made it to number one. Number one is Evelyn Adams. Now, I think if this is, yeah, here we go. Most people would be extremely lucky to win the lottery even once. New Jersey resident Evelyn Adams struck gold not once, but twice. Twice. And in consecutive years. I don't even want to read the rest of this. I ain't gonna lie. Winning a combined $5.4 million. However, she squandered this luck as she was a compulsive gambler and lost most of her money in Atlantic City. She also shared her funds with family and friends. And so before she knew it, she was flat broke living in a trailer park. She went from $5.4 million to a trailer park. Even though she was being generous, you just can't win the lottery twice and blow it. That's just spitting in the face of luck. Now, you know what's crazy is I'm gonna bring it all full circle. My wife and I watched the Squid Game last night, and at the very end, the coldest message of that whole movie, if you haven't seen it, it's a spoiler alert, so stop it right here and come back to it. But if you already seen it, you gonna know what I'm talking about. At the very end, the main character from the movie was talking to an older guy that set all the shit up. And the older guy spit some game to him so cold, I don't think most people even caught it. He said something along the lines of, what does a person with no money and a person with all the money in the world have in common? And the whole idea was, it's like, your life isn't shit on either end of the spectrum, being super rich or being super poor. Because when you're super, when you poor and you got no money, you can't go do shit. You can't do nothing you enjoy doing. And when you're rich, you've done everything you enjoy. You bought everything you can buy. It's like, what's left to work for? What's left to life? And I think that's one thing I took away from it, because this whole list of these 10 people shows you what happened. When you get it all, that doesn't mean that you just gonna live happily ever after and, you know, shit is all sweet from then. Unless you're smart with your money. If you're smart with it, yeah, that's how it plays out. But the majority or all of these people that want it, that's not how they live their lives. You know, people so used to not having shit, when they drop a briefcase on you with $5 million in it, like, the first thing most people think to do is just go ball heavy, and you see how that works. So there is a message to be taught in that. And to me, just to bring it back to the scrolls part of all of this, is if everything that you represent is materialistic, it's just gonna fall apart at some point. If you don't have any kind of foundation to you outside of money, if you don't wake up for a purpose other than money, then this is the type of shit that happens. But anyway, that's been the 10 dumbest lottery winners. These are some stupid motherfuckers. I mean, you hate to talk about people like that, but nah, them some stupid motherfuckers. Anyway, catch y'all in the next round. It's been the Scrolls Podcast. Peace.